Good evening, one and all. Myself Mahesh Reddy. I am working as a guest lecturer in mathematics from TTWRDC Medak. Today we are going to discussing about the 8th paper, vector calculus. In that, the mainly two major topics are there. One is line integral. One more is surface integral. This surface integral is related to the surface area. Look at that. Before going to discussing about the surface integrals, we have to know the surface area for vector fields, not the scalar fields. We already know that the vector fields have I, j, k terms, but the scalar fields have only x, y, z terms. For that, this is the parametric equation in the vector fields: f of uvi, g of uv, j, h of uv, k. So in that, the surface area, we get to know the surface area double integral length of the du dv in the cross product. So in this, the simplest manner is that f of x, y, z, we know the divergence of f and the length of the divergence of f dot p da double integral. This is said to be the surface area. For one more stage or the expand manner, we get to know the surface area is z is equals to f small f of x, y. The surface area could be changed as under root f x square plus f y square plus 1 da. This is all about the surface area. From the surface area, we get to know the surface integral. In the surface integral, the extra part or the extra calculation is that g of x, y, z. We are attaching this g of x, y, z, g of x, y, z to the surface area. It will becoming surface integral. Now the parametric equation for the surface integral is the same. Now the surface integral can be written in the three formats. The first format is in the format of g of f of uv, g of uv and h of uv in the length of the cross product ru, rv, dv, du. Now the implicit manner, in the implicit manner, we can get the surface integral formula as double integral g of x, y, z, length of divergent dot p da. Similarly, this is a explicit manner of know the surface integral. The double integral g of x, y and f of x, y under root f x square plus f y square plus 1 da. This is where these surface integrals are using. So the surface integrals are using, and the surface integrals can be taken from the total more surface area, the little part we have to take. In that, the mass of the shell, if you take the cone, this cone could be coated thin layer at the upper and the normal layer at the lower. This is based on to calculate this surface integral. Let delta x, y, z be the mass density of the thin shell. So the total mass should be taken as delta. The total mass double integral can be changed as the surface integral. We can say it is delta x, y, z d sigma, which can be the total mass of the shell which given here as a cone. Now the surface integral, in the surface integral, we can know that the relationship between the surface integral and line integral and area is much the same as relationship between line integrals and arc length. This is regarding the line integral and surface integral relationship. Suppose f is a function of three variables whose domain includes a surface S. So the function related to the domain a surface S. We will define a surface integral of f over S in such a way that in case where f of x, y, z is equals to 1, the value of surface integral is equal to the surface area of S. So we can get to know that this f of x y z is equals to 1, the value of surface integral is equals to the surface area of that. We start with the parametric surface, and again the surface integrals we have to going to discuss. Parametric surfaces. What are the parametric surfaces? Suppose that a surface have a vector equation. The vector equation should be in the format of r u v equals to x u v I, y u v j, z u v k, and u v is belongs to the d, which is belongs to a vector. So that's why it is a vector. So that's why we have to take that I j k. Now this d is a part where we have to take the total surface. Now we look at the first, assume that the parameter domain d is a rectangle. In this surface, this d is treated as a square box. In that square box, the rectangle box, sorry, so the rectangle box, and we divided it into sub rectangles r j i with domains delta u delta v. With the domains delta u delta v, this rectangle shape should be treated as d. Then the surface S is divided into corresponding patches S, I, j, as in the figure. Look at the figure. From this figure, we know that these can be split into two types. One is P, I, j and S, I, j. The surface is taken in the two formats. This parametric surface P, I, j, we evaluate F at the point in each patch multiple by the area delta Sj of the patch and from the Riemann sum. For after the getting the Riemann sum, we get the total surface of the particular area. Then we taken the limits as the number of patches increases, and the defined as this double integral, surface integral can be defined as the surface integral or double integral f of x y z ds equals to limit m comma n belongs to infinity, summation I equals to 1 to m and summation j is equals to 1 to n, f of p I j dot or f of p I j delta s I j, the multiplication of this have to taken as a surface integral. Notice the analogy with the definition a line integral, and also the analogy with the definition of the double integral. We get to know that in the line integral we have to take the one integral, in the surface integral we have to take the two integrals. To evaluate the surface integrals, in the equation one we approximate to patch area S I j be the area of an approximate parallelogram in the tangent plane. That rectangular plane are taken as a parallelogram. In the parallelogram we have to take that delta ISIJ. In our discussion of the surface area we made the approximation, so this is the approximation of the length already we have seen in the first slide, where RU is equals to dou x by dou ui plus dou y by dou uj dou z by dou uk, and RV, these are the RU and this is a RV, both are is there, or the tangent vectors at the corner of the Sij. The parametric surfaces, in that the one more thing, the components are continuous and RU and RV are non-zero. These are the two non-zeros. Why these two are non-zero? Because these are the length and these are the vector fields here, dou x, so this should be non-zero, which is not a zero, and non-parallel in the interior of D. It can be shown from the definition even when the D is not in rectangle. Already we know that D should not be the rectangle, D can be the parallelogram or D can be the square, anything else. That double integral f of x y z ds equals to this f function into the length of cross product of RU RV DA, so which is taken as a surface integral. Look at this should be compared with the norm formula for a line integral. This is the line integral, this is the surface integral, this is the difference between the surface integral and line integral. What is the difference between these surface integral and line integral? The surface integral are the double integrals and with the coded of r u v, and this is the r t. Only the single variable is present in here. Here it is two variable present in, and it is a cross product can be taken as curl, and here it is a dash. That means a differentiation. This can be taken as a as the formula to look at the example. Compute the surface integral x square ds, where s is a unit place, x square plus y square plus z square equals to 1. If look at the example, if question is given like this, compute the surface integral this one, we have to compute this one, where s is a unit place, unit sphere. The unit sphere equation is x square plus y square plus z square equals to 1. The solution is that we use the parametric representation, x equals to sine pi cos theta, y is equals to sine pi sine theta, z is equals to cos pi 0. So this z these three I have to take in here. Now the limit points or the range of the theta should be, and range of the pi should be taken as 0 to pi is a pi range, and 0 to 2 pi is a theta range. Here it is a theta and here it is a pi. That is r of the two functions pi. Already we know that here it is a uv instead of uv. Now we are taking that pi and theta. Sin pi cos theta I plus sin pi sin theta j plus cos pi k. So these are the x, y, z, means which can be written as xi plus yj plus zk. So in the place of x, we are taking sin pi cos theta. In the place of y, we have to take that sin pi sin theta. And in the place of z, cos pi. So we have substituted these three in xi, yj, zk. Now look at one more thing. Yeah, we can compute that length of the r pi cross product of r theta equals to sin pi. So this we have to compute after getting this length. We have to substitute in the double integrals like this. Now the solution for this one is pi. Yeah, integral 0 to 2 pi is the limit of the theta, and integral 0 to pi is the limit of the pi. Sin square theta, sin, we have to take here x square. What is the x square? X we already taken as x equals to sin pi cos theta. So in the place of x, we have to substitute sin pi cos theta. Square is there, that's why we have to take here sin square pi cos square theta. Next, the length of or the cross product of the r pi cross r theta is sin pi. We get recently, just now we get that this is a sin pi d pi d theta. Now integral 0 to 2 pi cos square d theta sin cube d theta can be taken as, why it is a sin cube pi? Sin cube because here already we have sin square pi and one more sin pi. Sin square pi into sin pi is getting sin cube pi. So that's why we have to take here sin cube pi. We know that, what we know that? The integration of cos square theta d theta is changed as, we know the formula for formula for cos 2 theta is equals to, one of the formula is that cos 2 theta, in the cos 2 theta 2 cos square theta minus 1 is also there. Cos 2a, the formula for cos 2a is that 2 cos square a minus 1. So 2 cos square a minus 1, from this y minus 1 we get here, and so cos square a should be changed as 1 by 2 of 1 plus cos 2a. So this 1 by 2 of 1 plus cos 2a we have to write here, and the formula for this sin cube d theta can be changed as sin pi minus sin pi cos pi d theta. We have to write like this. Now how can we get that sin cube should be changed as sin pi minus sin pi cos square theta? Because it is changed as, we can write this sin square pi d pi as sin pi next into sin square pi. So this sin square pi can be changed as sin pi is already there, the sin square pi is changed as 1 minus cos square pi. Now multiply this into internal, sin pi into 1 sin pi, sin pi into cos square pi sin pi cos square pi. This is how we get that. Now the integration for this one is integral 1 by 2 is a constant term, integral 1 dp, integral 1 dp is dt or dtp, d theta is theta, and integral cos 2 theta cos 2 theta is changed as sin 2 theta. So in that, here not x is there, 2x is there, so that's why we are getting in the denominator extra 2. Next, this is integral sin pi is a cos pi, and this can be taken as, put cos pi or sin pi cos pi as theta, cos pi as a theta, and d by dx of the cos pi is sin pi, sin pi d pi is changed as dt. Next, in the place of cos pi we put the t, integration of t square. What is the integral t square? So integral t square is t cube by 3. In the place of t we have to substitute that cos, so cos cube pi, the limits are 0 to pi. So the answer is finally 4 pi by 3 after solving this equation by substituting of the upper limit and lower limit. Next, parametric surface we can take like this also. If thin sheet, say aluminium foil, has a shape of surface S and density at the point xyz is O of xyz, then the total mass of the sheet is taken as the density into rho xyz is taken as the total mass of the surface. Surface integral of the vector field. Up to now we have seen parametric equation. Now we are going to see that integral, surface integral of the vector fields. Surface integral, what is the total volume of the fluid passing through the pipe per unit time? So what is the surface integral? What the volume flow rate is often called the flux fluid through the pipe or the flux of the fluid across the surface, yes, that forms the end of the pipe. The speed of the flow depends on the position within the pipe. The pipe has a square cross section with the walls x is equals to 0, 1 and y is equals to 0, 1. The small surface element with the area on the surface, small rectangular with the sides of the length dx and dy, is located at the point which is called the surface integrals we have to take now. Surface integral of the vector field. Suppose that S is a oriented surface surface with unit normal vector n, and imagine a fluid with the density rho xyz and the fluid. So which already seen just now. Now look at. We divide S into small patches. Already we discussed in the earlier sheets. The small patches we have to take in from that. We have to calculate the surface integral of that small tiny plot patches, after that the thin patches, thin total coated area or total mass, as in the figure 10. Yeah, this is a free picture, we have to see surface integrals of the vector field. The SJ is nearly planar, and so we can approximate the mass of the fluid per the unit crossing SJ in the direction of the normal by the quality. So this is the rho, and the density is taken as here, where P rho is evaluated. Yeah, right. This is the actual formula we have to take in the problems. By summing the quantities and taking the limit, we get according to the definition when the surface integral of the function is taken as rho cross dot product of n over s, double integral pv dot n ds, double integral rho xyz v xyz dot n of xyz ds. After getting the value of the rho xyz and v xyz, we put in n xyz together and get and doing the dot product, then we get the total surface area and integral surface integrals. This is the actual definition we are going to use in the problems. Yeah, if F is a continuous vector field defined on the oriented surface S with unit normal n, then the surface integral of F over S is the surface integral over S. We have to take that F dot n. This integral is also called the flux. So this integral is flux of F across S is also taken as like this surface integral. Surface integrals of the vector fields can be taken as like this also. Earlier sheets we have seen that these formulas in the T formats, one is implicit, one is explicit, and the one is normal formats of the formulas. Now look at the questions which is regarding the problems. The evaluated Q equals to double integral u dot xy ds, this is F what we are discussed up to now, where u naught x minus x square of y minus y square, where S is a square surface given by 0 to 1 and 0 to 1. The ranges of x, y is given by 0 to 1 and 0 to 1. Now Q is equals to, what is given here? The function is Q equals to double integral u naught of xy ds. Q, yeah, we just now know that x range is 0 to 1, that's why the integral one integral is taken as 0 to 1, and the y range is also 0 to 1, which is equals to 0 less than or equals to y less than or equals to 1. Similarly here also we have to take that 0 to 1. U naught xy equals to the function, which function is given here, that have to substitute. Which function is given here? U naught xy. What is a u naught xy function? X minus x square, y minus y square. we have to put here x minus x square, y minus y square. After that, after getting the integration with the x, from the x we get integral x dx is the x square by 2, integral x square dx is x cube by 3. In that the limit points are 0 to 1. After substituting the limit points we get 1 by 6, and the integration, after applying the integration we get y square 2 minus y cube 3, which is how the limit points 0 to 1, and 1 by 6 we get 1 by 6 into 6 is 1 by 36. This is the answer for the first question. Next, look at the question number 2. Evaluate the integral of the vector field u is equals to, the function is given here, u equals x z minus y over the curved surface of the cylinder, x square plus y square equals to 1. Means here f is also given, lying between z is equal 0 and z is equal to 1. The two parameters describing the surface and the height z and the angle theta around the cylinder, so which is given the cylinder. So now we have to find out the total mass of the cylinder. The surface integral of the cylinder, x is equals to cos theta, y is equal to sin theta, and z is equals to z. The given vector field u is equals to x z minus y over the curved surface of the cylinder, x square plus y square minus 1. So this is a cylindrical equation. Lying between z is equal to 0, the range of the z given as 0 to 1. X equals to cos theta, y is equals to sin theta, and z is equals to z also given. The x limits and the y limits are taken as x is equals to cos theta, y is equals to sin theta, and z is equals to z. R equals to, we know that R equals to xi plus yj plus zk. What is R? Xi plus yj plus zk. But here we have to take point format. In the point format we have to write xi, yj, zk as x, y, z. Now look at it. Applying partial differentiation to this R, after applying the partial differentiation we get 2 theta equals to, the differentiation for cos theta is minus sin theta, and sin theta is cos theta, and the z, any constant, is 0. So finally we get that 0 1 1. Why it is 0 1 1? The limits are here, we have to take that 1 only. Why? Z only present here, and x, y should be taken as zeros. Now the cross product we have to take, dou r dou theta into dou r dou z is equals to the both combination we get. Now applying this into surface integral, the value of the integral, after that we get that cos theta comma z comma minus theta, cos theta comma sin theta comma 0, d theta dz. Cos into cos is a cos square, I into I is a 1, plus next sin theta into 0 is a 0, z into sin theta is a z sin theta. Only two functions we are finally getting. We know that the dot product, for the dot product, I into I is 1, j is 1, k is 1, into means dot. I dot I is a 1, j is a 1, k dot k is a 1. Now, after applying the integration, we get integral 0 to 1 pi dz. We have to calculate here this answer. Next, integration pi can be, is a constant. Integrating 1 dz is z, limits are 0 to 1, finally we get that pi. Now look at the question number 3. Evaluate the surface integral of u equals to y comma x square comma z z square over the surface S, where S is a triangular surface. In the previous question, we are seen that which is given cylindrical shape. Here it is a triangular surface on x equals to 0 with y greater than or equals to 0, z greater than or equals to 0, and y plus z less than or equals to 1 with a normal n directed in the positive x direction. So which is the direction is given as x. Given vector fields is u is equals to vector field given means the function given. What function given here? The function given here is y x square z square. The triangular surface on x equals to 0 with y greater than 0, z greater than 0, y plus z less than 1. These all are given from in the question only. The normal vector is in positive x direction is n is equals to 1, 0, 0. U dot n, we have to find out for the surface integral is u dot n or s f dot n or r cross product dot u n v n, like that have to take from this also. The one y dot 1 is the y, x square dot 0 is a 0, z square dot 0 is a 0. Here these can be written is in the point format. If you have written it in the scalar vector format, we have to write I, J, K. We know that in the dot product, I dot I is the one, J dot J is the one, and the K dot K is the one. Now, this one is that. Y plus Z is less than 1. We know that. For getting Z, we have to send Y to is equal to outside. It will becoming 1 minus Y. And z greater than or equals to 0. So means z should be in range between 0 to 1 minus y. And the y is in range between 0 to 1. Yeah. Now how to substitute that? The yz format. The without the z, we know we can get that u dot n is the y. Y only there. For the z, integral 1 dz is z, limit points are 0 to 1 minus y. So 0 to 1 minus y, we have to substitute, we get 1 minus y. These y should be multiply with the 1 minus y. We get that 1 into y is a y, y into y is the y square, and integration of y is y square by 2, and integration of y square is y cube by 3. We are getting this as 1 by 6. Let's find the surface integral of u is equals, next question this one is, find the surface integral of u equals to r over the part of the paraboloid. Mean in the first question they are given cylinder, in the next question means previous question they are giving triangular, now it is a paraboloid shape. Z is equals to 1 minus x square minus y square with z greater than 0 with the normal pointing upward. The given parabola is, the parabola should be in the format of z is equals to, paraboloid shape is z is equals to 1 minus x square minus y square. The parabola cuts the plane at two points. Those two points are u is equals x, y, z, u is equals to let x, y. So those two points are x and y. Now the tangent vector is obtained by differentiating u with respect to x and y. Du dx equals to du by dx equals to d by dx of u. U function is that x comma y comma 1 minus x square minus y square have to take. D by dx of x is 1. D by dx of y means it is a constant. Constant should be taken as 0. And here also same for the x. X only variable and the remaining are constants. In the 1 minus x square minus y square, x square is a constant and remaining two terms are variables. x square, sorry, it is a x square is a constant variable, and the y minus y square are the constants. 1 minus 0 minus 2x. Du by dy equals to d by dy of x, d by dy of y, d by dy of 1 minus x square minus y square. In the first time, we have to take from the x dx. In the next time, dy. Those two have to multiply the cross product. Du by dx cross du by dy. From the cross product, we are getting that I, j, k, 1, 0, minus 2, k, 0, 1, minus 2. It is not a k, it is a x. So, correction. It is x only. It is not a 2k, it is 2x minus 2y. I have to take here. And this is I, j, k, the debt matter in the matrices. Debt can be taken as plus, minus, plus, and the square matrices we have to take. From that, the multiplication from the debt of the 2 by 2 matrix, we get that n is equals 2xi, 2yj plus k. Next. So this one is u dot n ds equals to x comma y minus comma 1 minus x square minus y square into 2x 2y 1 dx dy. After multiplication of this one, we finally get x square plus y square plus 1 dx dy. U dot n could be changed as x square plus y square plus 1 dx dy. Next, the limit z is equals to 0, when the limit point z is equals to 0 have to taken. X square plus y square equals to 1, x should be from minus 1 to 1 have to take. So the x limits are 1 to minus 1, and the y limits are minus and the root 1 minus x square to and the root 1 minus x square, and the function is 1 plus x square y square. Next, integral x equals to minus 1. After the completion of this one, integral 1 is a y, integral x square means x square is a 1, and integral 1 dx dy is the y, and integral y square dy is y cube by 3. In that, the upper limit is 1 minus x square, the lower limit is minus 1 minus x square. This have to substitute in this. After getting that, integral x equals to minus 1 to 1 dx. Here it is a dx. Now, which can be changed as integral and the root 1 minus x square plus x square 1 minus x square 1 minus x square cube by 3 plus on the root 1 minus x square plus x square in the root 1 plus x square equals to on the root 1 minus x square whole cube by 3 dx. This is all the simplification we have to do. Next, we have to substitute that x limit or integral x. Where is the integral x? Integral x is here. We know the formula for and the root 1 minus x square could be changed as or could be taken as a square minus x square, and the root integral under root a square x square is x by 2, and the root a square x square plus 1 by 2 sin inverse of x is the formula for this one. This one is the formula is x by 2 the root a square minus x square plus 1 by 2 or a by 2 can be write a by 2 sin inverse x by have to take. And next, the formula is same similarly ए स्क्वायर माइनस एक्स स्क्वायर, ए स्क्वायर माइनस एक्स स्क्वायर फॉर्मूला इज एक्स बाई टू प्लस द रूट ए स्क्वायर माइनस एक्स स्क्वायर प्लस ए बाई टू साइन वर्स ऑफ एक्स बाई ए, इन दैट सेम सिमिलरली नेक्स्ट हैव टू सब्स्टिट्यूट दैट एंड द लिमिट्स हैव टू अप्लाई, फाइनली वी गेट दैट 3π/2 the answer for this one. We have to calculate or we have to simplify these all our own, not by the textbook or not by the material. We have to do this by our own. Then only we get to know the solution or the steps, every steps we get understand. Example number 4. Find the flux of the vector field. We know that the flux should be taken from the F dot SDS. How to take the flux? And F is equals to the flux of the vector field. F is equals to XYZ, capital F is equal to XYZ is equals to ZI YJ K XK. Across the unit sphere, the sphere equation is given. First of all, cylinder given, then next triangular shape, next paraboloid, now the sphere, the solution. As in the example 1, we use the parametric representation r of pi theta equals to sin pi cos pi I plus, as per the example 1, we did this solution. Then we do the F pi comma theta equals to cos pi I sin pi sin theta j sin pi cos theta k, and r pi cross r theta equals to sin square pi cos theta I plus sin square pi sin theta j and sin pi cos pi k. We already seen those first example, that's why I'm slowly fastly telling that. Therefore capital F r of pi comma theta is the cross product for r pi into r theta. This is actual formula for the surface integral. This is the example solution we get. Similarly, this one integral 0 to pi sin theta cos pi d theta, integral 0 to 2 pi cos theta d theta. The answer for our since we know that integral 0 to 2 pi cos theta d theta from the example 1 is a 0. Similarly here also same, the answer for this one is we get 0. Answer for this one is same taken as sine cube, and here it is sine square. These can be 0. So the answer is 4π/3. After simplification of these two, we have to do the simplification by our own. That's why I am giving here direct answer. The surface integrals of the vector fields. These are the vector field surface integrals we already know. F dot rx cross ry. Rx cross ry have to do the first, and then dot product between the surface or function given dot this rx ry. Surface integral of the vector fields F dot ds, again we are seeing this one also just now. The surface integral of the vector fields, for instance, if E is an electric field, then the surface integral will integral of S E dot ds, it is called electric flux. So when we have to take here E, it is a electrical flux E through the surface. Yes, on the important law of the electrical is Gauss law. In the Gauss law also we use this one, which says that not charge enclosed by the closer surface yes is the epsilon naught is a constant called the permittivity of free space that depends on the units means, which is all related to the electronics where we have to use it. The surface integrals of the vector field has also taken as this is symbol of the divergence, this is delta, this one is the divergence. Similarly, divergence can be taken as also. The rate of the heat flows across the surface S in the body is given by the surface integral. The rate of the heat also flowing by in the body can be calculated by the surface integrals, which is also very important. So thank you. I get to know that you people have to get better understanding about the surface integrals, which is mainly used in the physics for calculating the surface area, so total masses like that. Thank you. Thank you.